The ICICI Prudential Life Insurance IPO opens today. Lots of interest in this IPO for a number of reasons. Firstly, it's a 6,000 crore IPO, so it's a large public offering. But more importantly, it's the first of the large Indian insurers, pure play Indian insurers, to actually go public. That's the reason we're having this conversation today, to try and understand what investors should look for if they are interested in an insurance IPO or an insurance investment. Joining us to help us understand is Alpesh Mehta. He's Deputy Head of Research at Motilal Oswal. Alpesh, thanks so much for joining us.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
Alpesh, a very basic question, and you know, some of this is coming from a more retail investor standpoint than an institutional investor standpoint. If an investor is looking at an insurance IPO, this is the first, there'll be other listed insurance companies that come in. What are they looking at? Is it a play on the Indian consumer, the Indian saver? What is it a basic play on?
So it's largely a play on the Indian savings. So currently, if you look at the household financial savings, as a percentage of GDP, it's at around 11%, of which the insurance constitute hardly 20%. So the insurance penetration in India is hardly 2.5% of GDP. If you look at the world average, is at around 3.5%. So there is still a lot of way to go for us to reach to even 3.5% as a percentage of GDP. Some of the developed markets are more than 5% as well. The sector opened up in the year 2000 only, so it has been only 15 years, and during this 15 years, insurance space per se has seen a lot of ups and downs. So the private sector guys, after opening up of the sector, private sector guys could manage to get 55% market share. Now, then after the regulatory intervention in 2010 and 2013, this market share came down to almost 36-37%, and now again the guys have realigned their product portfolio. The market share is again going back to 50-54%, and if you look at the insurance premium growth over the last 2 years, it has been upwards of 15%. In case of private sector guys, it has been more than 20% as well. So there, it's a clear play on the improving savings ratio, increasing penetration. There is a huge protection gap in the insurance space. The protection gap is as high as around 90%. From an opportunity perspective, this is based on one of the agency estimates. The insurance penetration gap is almost 8.5 trillion December 2014. So it's a huge opportunity. One should participate into this opportunity because it's a multi-year story. It's not a 1 year or a 2 year story that one should be looking at.
But it's not been a very profitable industry so far, right? I think there was a McKinsey report earlier in the year which said that return on capital is quite low. But you think that's changing, or what is it? Or is it that some players are doing better than others?
So there is very little understanding about the insurance space in this country. One should not look at the profitability from a rated profit perspective, because typically insurance companies will start making money after third year or fourth year, because the first 3 years will be largely towards expenses. The upfront commissions are very high in order to generate business. So the new business strain is very high for the insurance companies. So typically insurance companies don't make much money in the first 3-4 years. As long as the person is renewing its policy and if the customer is staying with the company for a long term, then only insurance companies will start making money. So one should not look at only the stated profitability. One should look at the economic profitability of the business, and economic profitability after all the regulatory interventions has been improving. So some of the ratios that I would suggest that one should look at is the persistency ratio. What are the new business margins into this space for a company? What are the return? What is the return on embedded value? Return on embedded value is more like a ROE for any other company. So in case of banks and finance NBFCs, if you look at ROEs are around 18-20%. In case of an insurance company, ROEV, which is the return on embedded value, if any company which is making more than 15%, it's a decent enough number.
Let me talk about ICICI Prudential in particular now. I think one concern is on valuations, because in November of last year, they sold stake to a couple of investors, and at that time, the valuation was 32,500 crore. Now, at the upper end of the band, it's almost 48,000 crore. So that's a substantial jump. Why would an investor pay so much more just a few months down the road?
Okay. So if you look at after this transaction, there were a lot of transactions also took place. So one of the most important transactions which took place in the industry was the Max HDFC transaction. Now after the merger one can look at that as a benchmark for this space now, because it's a pure play listed entity. It's an indirect listing for the HDFC Life as well. So if you work out the numbers, then Max HDFC combo is trading at at around 3.7 times EV or on FY18 or on FY18 basis, whereas on the trailing basis is more than 4 times EV, whereas the ICICI Pru is coming at 3.1 to 3.4 times EV on FY16 numbers.
Okay, so you're saying it's still cheap, it's not overvalued at least.
Obviously, we won't be able to recommend anything because of the compliance things, but at least on a relative basis, it's relatively cheap as compared to HDFC Max Combo. Okay.
But they're very heavily dependent on ULIPs. That makes them a capital market play more than anything else, or at least subjects them to volatility in the capital markets?
Yes, but if you look at, as I started the discussion, the financial savings in India is improving. The capital markets, obviously, we are very positive on the capital markets as well. So if the growth rates are higher and if your new business margins are improving, your new business profitability growth will be much higher than the overall top line growth as well. So at least from that angle, the multiples are going to be high for the structural value. So the easy way to look at this space is price to embedded value, but one should actually look at this this space valuations is on the appraisal value basis, whereas the important one of the important component is the structural value, which is more dependent on the new business where profit growth, what is the multiple or what is the growth outlook on the capital market. So as soon as if you are positive on the capital markets and simultaneously if you are positive on the company operations in terms of improvement into the margins, the structural value number will be relatively higher.
Sure, but you should
Indian
be aware that there will be some volatility capital markets.
There would be. Company is focusing on improving the share of the protection business and the non-ULIP business. But at least in the near term, the mix is going to be tilted towards the ULIP business. And obviously, that will have its own share of volatility for it.
Just one last question from my side, Alpesha, and that's on the persistency ratios. So I think there's a big debate on, firstly, which is the right ratio to look at. There's the 13th month and then people look at the 61st month as well. They don't fare very well on the 61st month ratio basis.
They are one of the best on the 61st month persistency. Even the 13th month persistency is more than 80%. The 61st month persistency has gone up to more than 50%. Now it makes more sense to look at the 61st month persistency because lot of ULIP related changes happened in 2010. After that, insurance companies sold policies, and so the customers who got onboarded in 2011-12, that would have the impact on the 61st month persistency now. So if those customers are sticking with you and if that persistency ratio is improving, then it is good for the company, because higher the persistency, better is higher the persistency experience, better would be the new business margins, better would be the return on embedded value. So if the persistency is high, it's overall it's good for the company.
Okay. Alpesh, thank you so much. That's an early look at the ICICI Prudential Life Insurance IPO. The IPO is only open today, so we'll actually see whether the IPO does well or not. 3 days it's open, 21st of September is when it closes.